There they are. Good morning to everybody, and I hope you're having a good morning. Apurva is in East Delhi, Aishman in Delhi as well. Let's go to each of our reporters to find out what's really going on. But I'm interested really in my colleague Mandar and his surroundings. Mandar, it is a contest in Bhopal of really Hindu and more Hindu between Digvijay Singh and Pragya Thakur. Since you got to Bhopal, what have you picked up? What are the voters telling you off camera about what their considerations are this time?
It's really indeed a very, very interesting battle in Bhopal, because just now, as I've seen, Pragya Thakur, who has already casted her vote in her polling booth, and we have been there, she was saying that this is a dhramayagya in a way, and where all your vote should be given as an aahuti. That means sacrifice. So basically, this is something, a different kind of jargons which are being used in a democratic process, and this is what is a very strange thing. As you have rightly said, this is a kind of a hard Hindutva versus soft Hindutva, kind of a projection which has happened. The campaign itself was a very, very strong campaign, high decibel campaign, and especially while we know Pragya Singh Thakur and her background and from where she comes, but even Digvijay Singh has also gone ahead doing home, havan, yagya and other rituals across in Bhopal. So that shows how strong the sentiments as far as the religious sentiments are here in Bhopal. But at the same time, while we were talking off camera with most of the people, people were saying that they are not really familiar with Pragya Singh Thakur. Apart from that, people were at least knowing the stature of Digvijay Singh. Popularly, he is known as Raja Sahab over here. And especially when his stature is well known, he is well known, well received across in Madhya Pradesh. And therefore, this is possibly the best candidate the Congress could give here. Because remember, from 89 onwards, the seat of Bhopal has been a bastion for BJP. And this time round, it is really being challenged. That is what is the situation on the ground. But of course, people whom were talking about BJP, they were talking about Modi and not just Pragya Singh Thakur. So this is how the situation is completely split. And remember, looking at the December elections, looking at the 2018 assembly elections, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh itself is a vertically split state in terms of its opinion as far as people are concerned. Because the kind of votes were casted in assembly elections, those were very very much vertically split. 41% for BJP and 40.50% for the Congress. And Congress could get 114 seats, BJP could get 109 seats, and Congress could get to the power. So this is how, in last 5 months, possibly, if at all, if Kamal Nath has done certain things which are kind of giving a sense of trust to the people for whom they have voted, then obviously that will also change the situation. Remember, in these 8 seats which are going today for the polling in Madhya Pradesh, Guna is the only seat out of the 29 seats. Last time only 2 seats were with the Congress. Guna is one of them. And of course, a leader like Jyotiraditya Sindhya has won from there in 2014. But the most importantly, this time around, in these 8 seats, in this particular phase, Congress is also hoping at least 50% of those seats of all these 8 seats. So that means Congress has put together their efforts in a different way, in a well-organized way, keeping aside their factions within the party, and that's how they have shown the strength. On the ground, their people are there, on the ground, their booths are there. This was not the situation until last 2 elections in Madhya Pradesh, in Bhopal at least. So this is how the situation right now. You can see this is a long queue. Even women are there, young men are also there, and they are trying to go for the polling inside the booth. The kind of process, of course, everywhere this time around, what we have noticed is the initial process of the polling is very, very slow. It goes by snail speed, and that's why people have to wait like this. This is the area where you can see people are really standing for a long time. Almost last half an hour, all these women are standing over here. That also is one of the putting a factor for the voters, because voters cannot really be patient for that much of time. Faye.
All right, Mandar joining us from Bhopal.